Let's build a low-cost or even a zero-cost earth oven. This will be perfect for making pizzas. You'll only need some bricks, clay, sand, and water. That's it. This oven cost nothing to build. Alan, who is one of my three sons, was home visiting, and he volunteered to do the physical work. I would only assume a supervisory role. The baking surface on this oven will be circular, 19 inches in diameter, big enough for a pizza or a loaf of bread. We're going to build the oven right on the ground, and that's why we removed the sods. We could have left the sods in place, but I think we can do a better job if we put some sand down, because this would make a better foundation to hold our floor bricks. Tamp the sand down and just eyeball it to try and get it level. You can buy a new brick for a little less than a dollar and maybe a used one for 25 cents, but often you can get bricks for free if you live in the country and just ask around. Often people have stacks of old bricks they'll no longer use, and they keep them behind outbuildings and sheds. We used approximately 25 used bricks for this oven. We're now going to build a sand form for our earth oven. I should say Alan is going to build the form, and it will be about 12 inches high by 19 inches wide. The sand I found alongside a gravel road, and it took about 10 kitty litter pails to complete the job. I don't like to use the 5-gallon plastic buckets because when I fill them with sand or other material, they're just too heavy. It is the sand form that defines the shape of the oven. Next, we have to prepare our clay sand mixture. Now thoroughly mix one part of clay to two parts of sand, adding a little bit of water. You'll need about 3 kitty litter pails filled with clay and 6 pails filled with sand. I dug up the clay in my backyard. If you can't find any in your backyard, then you might ask around and probably you'll come up with some. If necessary, you could always buy some clay at a pottery supply store. A masonry supplier might also stock fire clay. We'll refer to this clay-sand mixture as mud, because that's really what it is. You should cover your sand form with about a 3-inch thickness of mud. The little stick on top of the dome is merely a guide to help you to determine how thick your mud should be at the top. When you're done mudding up your dome, whack it and shape it with a 2x4. This will help to compress the mud on the dome. Now we're ready to make an opening for our earth oven. Using a knife, cut a small opening first and gradually enlarge it to about 7x14 inches. Sand and build a fire in your earth oven. Use the driest wood you can find to build your fire. Build the fire on the outside of the earth oven where there is the maximum amount of oxygen. Once the fire gets going, then slowly push the fire into the oven. After a 2-hour burn, our oven was approximately 80% dry, dry enough to start baking. If you're a beginner, make some flatbreads. Nothing could be more fun and easier. Not counting the time we spent assembling materials, it took about an hour and a half to construct the oven, and then we fired it for a couple of hours. So from nothing to something to a completed oven, we were able to start serving bread in about 3.5 hours. Not bad. If you want to make some sort of Buddhist statement about the impermanence of matter, then don't even bother to cover your earth oven, because after it rains, it will go back to its source, and that is simply mud. Alan and I thought we'd like to keep the earth oven around for a while, so we simply covered it with the old wheelbarrow that we had mixed the mud in. Ideally, you really want to build your earth oven off the ground, and that will certainly help to protect it. Let's look at some simple earth ovens that were built off the ground. Here's an earth oven that was built on top of a trash can. Now we're looking at an earth oven that was built on top of a tree stump. And on a set of sawhorses. Here's an earth oven being built on top of a tiny refrigerator. Maybe they were planning to store firewood inside. Check out this fine earth oven constructed by Brian Baker. The oven sits on top of a truck tire. Finally, here's an earth oven built in Greece by Gabriel Harrell, and he claims his oven could be wheeled away from disgruntled police or fire marshals very quickly.